Hello, mamas. My name is Jennifer Elwood, intern at Seeing Deep Ministries and founder of the Refuge Bible Study Community, where we cultivate our faith in the shelter of God's Word. And I'm here to share a motherly musing moment from biblical history. We are going to focus in on the topic of gratitude today and open up scripture to peer into the life of a mother from biblical account, Eunice. She is the mother of Timothy, who was a close associate of Paul and to whom two letters were personally written in the Bible. The reason we know about her is because Paul specifically reminisced about Eunice in 2 Timothy 1:5, which I'll read from the NIV translation. I am reminded of your sincere faith, which first lived in your grandmother Lois and in your mother Eunice, and I am persuaded now lives in you also. I learned studying the Bible from a cultural and historic perspective that Jewish people carefully consider the meaning of the name that they give their child because it defines them. And Eunice means good victory. The dictionary defines victory as overcoming your enemy. And isn't that the goal of all Christ-loving mothers everywhere contending for their children and teaching them about their faith? What we can glean from her story is that she did this well. Paul and Barnabas first visited Lystra, which is a ways inland from the Mediterranean in modern-day Turkey. During Paul's first missionary journey, commentators believe it's likely he met Timothy and his mother and grandmother then, and perhaps that their conversion came at that time. We first see Eunice mentioned in Acts 16:1, which takes place during Paul's second missionary journey. This is from the NLT translation. Paul first went to Derbe, then to Lystra, where there was a young disciple named Timothy. His mother was a Jewish believer, but his father was Greek. So here she is, mothering a son and perhaps other unnamed children with a Greek husband whose faith affiliation we are unaware of. I wonder how she felt, because it seemed from that passage that she strived to pass on her faith alone in her home. But we later learn in scripture that she enjoyed the encouragement and faith of her own mother, Lois, who Paul also mentioned. Can you just imagine them walking in sandaled feet on a dusty pathway to someone's home church, if you'd like to call it that, bringing Timothy and the other children with them and exposing him to the fullness of Jewish faith he was raised with. The truth of the Messiah's coming happened in their lifetime. And can you imagine the joy she witnessed when her son was chosen by Paul? All that persistence in teaching her precious child about the living God had paid off. We see Paul mention this again in 2 Timothy 3:15 in the NIV translation, and how from infancy you have known the Holy Scriptures, which are able to make you wise for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus. And, you know, I hope that joy of her son's obedience and his resulting faith reached into her soul later when she received news that her son was beaten or imprisoned for his faith. Though the word is not specifically mentioned, what I see in this story unfolded is gratitude for mothers who shared their faith boldly and passionately with their children. So effectively, in fact, that we experienced their triumph of partnering with God to teach their children about him over 2,000 years later. What woman in your life mothered you in faith? For me, I have fond memories of my grandma, Hildegard Frank, sharing what Jesus meant to her, sometimes with little tears in her eyes. For this, I am eternally grateful. She shared her faith with her daughter, my mother, Linda, who for my entire life pointed me to Jesus, to notice his exquisite handiwork in nature and his love and goodness during the ups and downs of my life. I will have the privilege of celebrating her 70th birthday on Thanksgiving this year. And as I'm writing this, my gratitude is turned into overdrive. So mamas, let's cultivate a heart of gratitude this coming week as we sojourn towards Thanksgiving. Let's remember those whose faith impacted our own and count our blessings. And take heart that all your persistence to impart your faith to your children will pay off, because the living word does not return void. Perhaps someday you will experience your own children walking in the way of Jesus and delighting in their sincere gratitude for you. Thank you from the bottom of my heart for listening, and I hope you leave this space encouraged. Happy Thanksgiving!